Hello, I'm Graham and I hope everyone's having a great day and welcome to part 5 of my photography on a budget series. Now in today's video we're going to look at full frame cameras, and in particular this is the Canon 5D, the original Canon 5D, sometimes called the Classic, other times called the Mark 1. It's 15 years old, it came out in 2005 and looks a professional grade camera, but unfortunately it doesn't have weather sealing or anything like that. It was a increment to the 20D, which came out in 2004. So this was like the first of the serious amateur cameras that Canon brought out. So it's a mirror camera, it's a DSLR because we've got a viewfinder, which is optical, no electronic viewfinder. We've got an LCD screen which allows us to look at the menu, and it's only 2 inches with 203 kilodots, so not very high resolution, but enough to see your menu and a quick preview of what you've captured, but not the quality that we're used to seeing on the later cameras with a 3-inch or 3.25-inch screen. Now, these cameras are becoming rarer and rarer, and unfortunately there was a problem with these cameras in terms of the mirror coming detached. There was a recall in 2009 and I think the final update was closed off in 2015, so if you hadn't had the camera upgraded to the new mirror mount, then unfortunately you're left up the creek without a paddle, because Canon won't touch the cameras now, they're saying there's no parts available. Now unfortunately this one has had some damage in the past, the mirror has been chipped in the corner. Whether it's been hit by a lens or whether someone's trying to fit an EFS lens in there and the mirror's come up and hit the back of the lens, I don't know, but the corner's chipped off, but unfortunately that doesn't appear in the imaging area and it's not in the optical path for the autofocus, so I'm not too concerned about that, it worked perfectly well. There's something about shooting with a full frame camera. When I first bought my 5D in, let's see, 2016, the first time I put some images through that camera, I was absolutely blown away with it. The very next day I went back to the local dealer that I bought that 5D from. He had a 5D Mark III in the window. I knew I was going to shoot my daughter's wedding, so I asked him if he'd buy back the 5D, and I bought the 5D Mark III along with this 24 to 105L series lens at that time. So that's how I started off my full frame collection, and over the period of time I've added a macro lens, the 100-200, the 85-1.8, the 50-1.4 and the 70-300. I did have a 100-400 zoom, but I recently sold that off as I wasn't using that as often as it should be used, so I managed to sell that back to Park Cameras, I believe. So this one cost me £268 from eBay, body only, and it consisted of the body and this BG4 grip. So they're worth about £70 themselves these days on eBay. So if I manage to sell this camera as a body only and the grip only, then I might be able to make a slight profit when I do sell this camera back, if I decide to do that. The camera itself is a 12 megapixel camera, so it's not the highest spec, but remember 2005, this was the first of the Canon CMOS cameras. Prior to that we've been using CCD, so this was Canon's first CMOS sensor, and it's got a certain appeal. When you start to use this camera you can see the images and you think, wow, that is something you really do like. The first shots I took through here were some plants, some flowers. I was absolutely blown away by the depth, the colour, the look of the image. I just had to go for a higher resolution one because I owed it to my daughter to get the very best from a wedding dress, etc. So I went for the 5D Mark III with an enhanced resolution. But as you've seen from the series already, resolution doesn't really come into it when you're only projecting them to social media sites where you're only using small resolution files, or if you're only printing up to say A4, but I wanted larger prints than that, so I needed the higher resolution. But having said that, if you're a Photoshop user, you now know we've got the enhanced facility where we can double the resolution of our images. So technically I can take the 12 megapixel RAW file from here and upgrade that to a 24 megapixel image as that Photoshop as the super enhanced or super resolution mode now. I've tested that out and it does appear to work. It works better with my Fuji X-T4 than it does with the camera raw files from the Canon, but it does appear to have some benefits, and I'll be looking at that a little bit more closely in a future video. So this camera is a beauty to use. I'll just put the 85mm lens on here, line up the red dot to the mount. It only shoots at 3 frames per second, so let me just turn that on. Let's listen to the shutter sound. Something about that noise. Obviously it's not silent shooting, you're not going to get away with this in a quiet environment, or if you're shooting wildlife, that shutter sound can be a distraction. There's no way of turning off it's that, the beauty of that mechanical shutter. It has a bright optical viewfinder. It's not electronic, so you've not got the facility of just previewing your image as soon as you shot it. You've got to take it away from your eye and chimp on the back of the screen if you want to see how your image has looked. But quite honestly, once you've got the exposure mode set, it appears to give you great resolution and good exposure without having to do too much with the exposure compensation dial. I've tested it out in all modes, in the auto mode, the P mode, the A mode, the manual mode, and I've shot some flash with it, and it appears to work fine in all modes, so there's no problem with the mechanical reliability of the camera as far as I can see. And in terms of abuse, no, there's none. The body is fine. Usual wear on the top of the flash housing here, where that's where you'd expect. No marks on the screen where that's not been rubbing against the body, so the screen has not been damaged in any way, and the body is in fine condition. So apart from that chip on the mirror, which I said isn't a showstopper, it's a perfectly good camera to use. Now for natural history photographers, wildlife, that sort of thing, you're probably still better using APS-C, as you've got the 1.6 times crop factor, so that multiplies your native lenses by 1.6, so something like the 200 becomes a 300 and something mil focal length, so you're getting that extra reach, and something like the 300 here becomes 460mm, so you're getting a good reach on the APS-C cameras, so you can use them for wildlife. But having said that, when you want full frame and you want that shallow depth of field, these cameras do give you that facility. Now these cameras have large pixels and show off their strengths in low light. In fact, I've had problems because I've been using small sensor cameras for so long and having to use base ISO of 100 all the time. It's been a real struggle to try and push myself into the ISO 400 or 800, which this camera will happily work at without any noise showing. For me to get faster shutter speeds or shallower depth of fields, I just have to up my game to think about using higher ISOs for faster shutter speeds. So it's a learning curve. Even though I've got the 5D Mark IV, I still struggle at times to move away from base ISO when conditions would warrant using either a faster shutter speed, a smaller aperture, or a combination of both. Anyway, that's the 5D Mark I, or the classic. So on eBay you're going to be paying something like £200-ish for a body if it's in reasonable condition. Get the seller to give you a picture of the mirror in the camera, as the one which have been upgraded by Canon will have a reinforcement up the side of the mirror mount to show that it's been done. Sometimes they issued a certificate to show the camera had been upgraded. If you can just see a plain mirror, then it may be a problem that at some point in time that mirror is going to detach. You can glue them back yourself, but it's not such an easy job. And you still can get mirrors on eBay. There's £35 if you wanted to replace the mirror. I may do that with this camera eventually, so I can sell it off in pristine condition and probably get a little bit more money for it rather than trying to sell it with that chipped corner. Some people might not appreciate the fact that it doesn't affect the image quality. It's just a cosmetic blip. So let's have a look at some of the images I've been shooting with this camera, give you an idea of what a full frame camera can do, what it looks like, and the sort of situations that you're going to find yourself having to switch lenses, because remember it's not a zoom or a bridge camera, so you're going to have to change lenses quite often if you want to go from wide angle to ultra telephoto. So that's one thing to consider. The weight is another issue. With the battery grip on here, this is quite a weighty camera to carry around in your camera bag. So that plus a telephoto lens, you're talking several kilos worth of camera gear. Anyway, enough of my ramble. Let's just have a look at some images, see the quality you can get from these cameras, and I'm sure you'll be impressed by what you'll see. So that's the Canon 5D Classic, or the Mark 1, full frame DSLR camera with a CMOS sensor, the first of the CMOS sensors brought out by Canon back in 2005. Now in the next video I'm going to be looking at some more advanced Micro Four Thirds system, the GX8 and the GX85. Going to pay a little bit more than, say, £160. You're going to be talking £400, but they're still cheaper than the more modern bodies. And you're going to still get a lot of facilities like 4K photo shooting with those cameras. So a lot of advantages. The GX85 doesn't have a mic input, but the GX8 does. Unfortunately, it's a 2.5mm, but you can easily adapt that to 3.5. So we'll have a look at those cameras in the next video. So if you're not already a subscriber and you're liking what you see here, do hit that subscribe button and the bell notification icon, and then you'll be advised when I upload new videos. And if you've not seen my photographic blog, do check that out. I'll put a link to that in the video description below. Also on the homepage is the application to join my newsletter group. That goes out to just under 4,000 people now every month. It's more than a newsletter, it's almost a photographic magazine these days with the technical stuff that I push out there that I don't put on the blog. And that's a way of saying thank you for your subscription. So, until the next video, as usual, I may have got a haircut by then, as we're only 13 days to count down to the barber's opening, so hopefully I'll get a haircut by then. So, until then, as usual, take care, and I'll talk to see you all in the next one. Goodbye for now.